Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa Natthi raga samo agge, natthi dosa samo kale, natthi kanda samo dukkha, natthi santi param sukante. Dear Venerables, dear devotees, we recite a Dhammapada verse. It comes from the Sukhavagga, happy section. The Buddha preached Dhamma while residing at Jetavana Monastery. But not in the monastery, Buddha preached Dhamma in a village. One of the wedding ceremony, after wedding ceremony, they offer Sangadana. Because of this Sangadana, Buddha explained Dhamma to the people there, who gather there. In the Dhamma, Buddha explained the fire as like the lust. There's no fire as like the lust. Is the highest fire. And also disasters, also not disaster as like the hatred. Hatred is the highest disaster. The suffering, also highest suffering is the aggregate suffering. Highest happiness is the liberation, Nibbana. Buddha had been explaining few things on that time. Reason is new marriage couple, after the marriage ceremony, they invite Buddha and Sangha. Sangadana. So Buddha and Sangha go there to the house. Many people, they are very respectfully. They are preparing Sangha and Sangadana offering. The girl, newly married one. Girl also doing lot of work. She is offering food, cleaning and many things. She also doing. But boy, husband, he don't have any of the wholesome mind. He keep focusing of his girl. Or his wife, or that he focused for the beauty, or that when she was doing this work, that her legs, hand, body, movement, this thing had been focusing, but no any duty to the Sangha. Buddha saw it. So Buddha determined not to see the girl to the boy, husband, not to see the wife. So then, sometimes later, his object, the girl object or wife object, reduce. Then his mind come to the normal now. Now we understand. That time Buddha call him and also others. Buddha explain, boy, you understand now that fire is like the lust, there is no. It's the highest fire in the world. And also disasters as like the hatred, there is no. This is the highest disaster. Suffering also, Buddha explaining, highest suffering is the aggregates, highest happiness is liberation. By focusing it, Buddha preached Dhamma to the boy and all the listeners. Many, they listen Dhamma, the boy also could attain extreme entry, many others also could attend sampad and proshas. In the Dhamma, Buddha explained lust or the traga is the highest at the fire. To understand, when we don't have the lustful mind, mind very peaceful, very comfortable. If the lustful object come, not easy, but burning, not easy, very difficult, uncontrollable. Wisdom not work, mind not proper because of the lustful mind. Same way, the hatred mind. If no hatred, mind very comfortable. With the hatred mind, so many difficulties come. Many disasters come, bodily, mentally, many disasters with the hatred. And also aggregate suffering, you know, the body, we are suffering with the body. And also mental part, also other aggregates, the five aggregates, all aggregates we are suffering. If anyone attain liberation, the highest happiness there, attainment. So Buddha explaining. So we also facing this kind of things. Some of the difficulties, these defilements, so that, and also one day we can overcome all the defilements, one day we can attain liberation, we can achieve highest happiness. So the Buddha explained the raga or lust is the highest fire that we understand in our heart. How much this lustful fire we have, so that we, if we ask Venerable how we can overcome this lustful mentalities. Various venerable can explain various way. Some venerable can say, I overcome with the faithful object, Buddha Anusati. Some they can say, I can overcome with the metta, loving kindness. Some they can say, other meditation, samatha or vipassana. This way we can say, some extent can be the correct, some extent may not be the correct. So that the real lustful mentalities we can overcome with the correct practice. Meditation object can do it. Correct meditation object, effective meditation object can do it. The wisdom, there are three types. The Sutamaya Jnana, Chintamaya Jnana, Bhavanamaya Jnana. That Sutamaya is we call reading and listening knowledge. Chintamaya is that thinking knowledge. Bhavanami is practicing knowledge. So that we learn Buddha's teaching, or that we learn with the various ways, listen as Dhamma. Now we are also explaining Dhamma. You can read the Dhamma, Dhamma books. So various ways you can have some knowledge. But that knowledge cannot overcome this lustful defilements. Can little bit reduce, but cannot overcome. So after learning, that we learn, that we learn five bodily parts or 32 parts or elements. After learning, we are thinking. The thinking also a little bit can reduce further. Thinking knowledge also valuable, but little bit only can reduce. Completely we cannot overcome it. Later, we go to the meditation knowledge. We train at the meditation practice. So meditation practice can overcome it. Meditation can do it. So one of the example we explain, one venerable here, a few years before, venerable come here and his mentality many agitation. So that time venerable said, I cannot practice anapana. I had been practicing 1.5 years, but no results. Can Bhante give another meditation object? So we more interested 32 parts. We says yes. We taught him 32 parts, bodily parts, meditation object. Venerable also respectfully accepted and asked, can I practice until the deepest attainment? We says yes, you can practice up to the deeper concentrations. So Venerable, he had been practicing 32 parts. Every week he come and report. Whole week he keep silent and no talk at all. He keep whole week silent and practice. So week by week, he get the reports. He report his meditation results. 1 week he, after that he says very comfortable. Second, third, fourth, he says now very comfortable, very brighter now. So after 2 months, he come and say, oh Bhante, I feel like I am arahant now. No defilement, I don't feel any of the lustful thoughts or any of the defilements I can't see. Venerable had been explaining. So this is the results we are expecting with the meditation. So meditation only can do this part. So we can focus how much lustful mentalities we had during the daytime. So this object is suffering for us because of this
fire, suffering for us, we had to overcome. Then only ordination life is very comfortable. Any of the lustful objects come, we can stay without lustful. So because of the our practice is stronger. One occasion, Varidama Mahathera, he had been spending the Vassana with the meditation practice. After Vassana, explained to the Sangha, whole Vassana I had been practicing. So during the Vassana, even one of the lustful thoughts I didn't get, even one of the lustful thoughts didn't have. So we can focus ourselves how much lustful thoughts I had during the daytime. If we have, means our practice is still not good. We have to build up more and more practice. Then one day you also get this ability. You also can live without any lustful object. So this practice is doing this part. We need effective practice. We need effortful practice. We need continuous practice. So that we have to determine in future mentality, we keep your lustless mentalities. So we know the now lustful mind can overcome with the meditation object. We explain it. Hatred also Buddha explained is very big disaster. Also big harmful for life if hatred there. We can focus how much hatred we had from morning until now. How much hatred we have means our mentality is not well developed. So that hatred can overcome with the meditation practice. Everyone can say various way. Hatred we can overcome with the loving kindness. We all can overcome with the Buddhanusati. Various way we can say. But real way we need to develop meditation. Any of the way we have to train meditation until the concentration, until the deeper level experience of the meditation. Then Buddha explained the aggregate suffering is the highest. The suffering aggregates, you know that we have the birth, we are aging, later we are getting sickness and we are dying, again rebirth, those aggregates we are suffering. So only way is the liberation, is the happiness. Highest happiness is liberation. We practice up to the liberation, then we can attain highest happiness. Why we are suffering with the lust? Why we are suffering with the hatred? Why we are suffering with the aggregates? Reason is the mental factors. Some of the mental factors in our mind weaken. That's why we are suffering. You know, among the mental factors, mindful factor very weaken. Concentration factors weaken. Wisdom factors weaken. That's why we are suffering. When the mindfulness factors is stronger, then we are not suffering. And also concentration factors is stronger, we are not suffering. Wisdom factors is stronger, not suffering. These three factors together, other factors, we have to have in a good level. In our mentalities, generally, these factors very weakened. So mindfulness, concentration, wisdom very weakened. So mindfulness, we can see from morning until now how much mindfulness I had. Concentration, how much object I had, concentration object. Wisdom, how much formations I understand. When we are focusing, we understand our level very weakened. That's why lustful object, hatred object, and also suffering object remain. If we are practicing meditation practice, you can bring up mindfulness. When the mindfulness is stronger, all lust, hatred, and suffering disappear. When you bring up the concentration, when you bring up your wisdom, all these difficulties disappear. So meditation doing this part. Meditation does this part, bring up your these factors, and because of these factors become stronger and stronger, your life become very comfortable. No lust, no hatred, no suffering. Yes, sir? So we have to understand in meditation, we have to bring it up. So then this silent meditation, we determine to bring it up. So without this meditation development, without this meditation factors come up, you are expecting happiness of the ordination, but never can happen. If you bring up these factors, definitely you are happier. Your mindfulness, you are happier. Your concentration, you are happier. Your wisdom, you are happier. So you don't have the defilements, you are happier. You are very comfortable all the time, tranquil. You are sitting tranquil all the time, comfortable. Life is very comfortable. So we determine during this retreat, silent retreat period, We determine to bring those factors up. If you give a little bit chance for meditation, you never experience even the calmness. You give a little bit chances only for meditation development, so that never experience. If you have to give big chances, that means in your mind you have to keep big space for the meditation. Then only you can experience. If you give a small space, you never experience at even tranquility, calmness, you never experience with the meditation. You are doing meditation, but you never. But if anyone keep big space for the meditation practice, you are protecting meditation practice as like the gem you are protecting. You are always protecting your meditation objects. Definitely, you can experience continuous mindfulness. You can experience continuous concentration. You can experience continuous wisdom. Life is very comfortable. That now you understand Avaridham Mahathera. When he was there in the forest and practice 3 months, no defilements, all the time meditating, no defilements means you understand mindfulness is stable, concentration is stable, wisdom is stable. That's why Mahathera got disability. And also other venerable we explain. Also he said later, after 2 months practice, he explained, I don't have any defilements, I feel like I am Arahant. Means his practice also mindfulness is stable, and also concentration part is stable, wisdom part is stable. This part doing by the meditation practice. So meditation, effortful meditation is very important. We determine to fulfill this meditation practice during these 5 days. So later Vassana period also we determine to continuous practice and experience deeper mindfulness, deeper concentration and deeper wisdom. So determination, together we start our meditation retreat. So the meditation practice, it is very important we maintain continuously and effortfully. We have to give big chance for the meditation development, big space in our heart. Then we can experience deeper meditation results. We explain mental factors, mindful factor, concentration factor, wisdom factor, those factors have to bring it up. Then only meditation is very comfortable. If not, meditation not effective. When you are practicing time, mindfulness not coming up, concentration not coming up, wisdom not coming up, your meditation not effective for you. So effective way is these factors have to come up. You have to maintain your meditation object, continuously have to maintain. When you are maintaining, that you have to understand your sitting posture. Sitting posture is Buddha explained, cross leg, body upright. This is the best one. But immediately don't force it. If you pause immediately, say cross leg, body upright, sometimes body tension can happen. Some too much pain can happen. It will relax, say first sit. 4-5 minutes, just relax. No need to fully cross leg, some simple way cross leg. And also body upright, not necessarily fully upright, little bit. After few minutes, the body, your muscles get a little bit relaxed. Then slowly, slowly, you adjust your body and legs. So if you keep body a little bit upright, muscles also comfortably sit. Now you are very comfortable in the sitting posture. After that, again have to relax. You keep body upright, leg, and also cross leg, then relax. If tense, meditation results very slow. Sitting posture, if tension together, you sit leg tension, later knee pain, leg pain come. Back also, you try to keep body upright very hardly, later difficult to develop meditation. So we have to relax. This is very important, sitting posture. Meditation object also, immediately don't focus meditation object. If you focus immediately meditation object, very easy get tension. Very easy difficulties. Very relaxed way start. Simple way start. Simply focus meditation object. And simple way, if you focus breath, very simply focus many other wandering thoughts together. Simple breath focusing. Many other wandering thoughts, that's true beginning. Together wandering, just focus breath in, breath out. Very simple way. So gradually, you increase your energy. After 4, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, slowly, slowly your attention, your focusing you increase. 5 minutes, 10 minutes later, you increase your focusing or your attention. Then 20 minutes, further increase your attention. 30 minutes you keep more attention, more focusing, then your tranquility very fast come. Beginning you do it too much attention, tranquility not come, concentration not come. If you gradually increase focusing ability, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, then tranquility come, very easy meditation. After that, no pain, bodily no pain, focusing object also very comfortable, easy maintain that every sitting. So this maintain is very important. So sometimes we feel some laziness for the meditation practice, it is harmful for you. But even some painfulness, some difficulties, simple way you are maintaining meditation, today maybe not results, tomorrow you get the results because you are maintaining your meditation object. So determine to have this meditation object during these 5 days. First day definitely no good results. The second day also no very good results. Normally third day very good results. So that first day we maintain bodily pain and still practicing. Second day also little bit pain and still practicing. Third day less pain, very comfortable practice. So until these results determine and maintain continued practice, definitely you can experience very good results during this 5 days meditation practice. So the meditation objects, we all have the experience. So your experience you can follow for the meditation practice. We are not going to explain detailly here the meditation object. If it is breath, you can focus breath with the counting. Breath in, one, breath out, one. If the counting is comfortable, after few minutes comfortable, you can do the notification. Breath in, breath out. So after some time, is that also comfortable? That without notification, you just focus breath in, breath out. When you are focusing, your mindfulness getting better and better, comfortableness getting better and better. So your concentration is appearing, mind getting brighter, very brighter. Whole room, sometimes whole area brighter, very comfortable. After that meditation, very easy. If the brightness there, very easy to go to the jhanas, absorption. So this way you can train the samatha object, you can train up to the absorption levels. If it is vipassana brightness appearing, vipassana knowledge is appearing. So both way we need to train. First we need samatha experience, later we need vipassana experience. So in order we have to train this meditation practice, we determine during this period. Sitting posture, we all have the experience. Not hard posture, simple way, relaxed way, we sit in posture and we try to keep body upright but relaxed way. Don't force, don't tense. Meditation object training we explain. First 5 minutes we don't force, simple way start. Second 5 minutes little bit increase energy. Third 5 minutes little further increase energy. 30 minutes already very good level of energy. Very easy, tranquil, very easy, comfortable, very easy meditation results. So this way we try to develop this meditation practice during these 5 days. Actually don't have the 5 days even, 4.5 days because our Patimokkha day is the last day. We have the only 4.5 days. We determine during the 4.5 days, very deep experience, concentration, and also brightness, and also absorption. Later vipassanas, we determine. So we know our venerables working very hard. So during this period, effortfully we train, definitely you can experience this deeper dhamma. Later your life is valuable for you, life is valuable for the Buddha Sasana. So the meditation program, we determine to maintain continuously. Our mental background now is very good level because we all have the very valuable merits. Last few days we had very valuable merits and effortful merits. Venerables, they organize pujas, pagoda puja, and also opening the pagodas, and also some other offering items, offerings, requisites to the building pagodas, and other monasteries also we are offering some items and requisites. So various ways we accumulate merits. Those merits base is more useful for our life. So that when we are doing this kind of merits respectfully, those teachers, they are giving their blessing to us. Those blessings also useful for us to fulfill our works. You know, the parents, they are thinking of their son and daughters, and they are thinking of may they fulfill their education or practice. This wish is very big energy for the children. Similarly for us, our teachers' blessings, very big support, blessing for us to develop our ordination life practice, fulfill our practice is very big support. So we are very lucky. All the senior teachers always blessing for us so that our sanghas, they are blessings. Our even the yogas from senior teachers also they are blessings all the time. So we are very lucky to have these blessings. In this ceremony also we got all those blessings. So we are lucky. So together these blessings, we determine to maintain our practice, effortful practice. So we determine and to fulfill our practice during these 4 days, 5 days. So we wish all the venerables fulfill their all the practice, experience, dhyana concentration, experience, vipassana knowledges. Wish all the venerables fulfill all the practice and attain for the path, provisions and nibbana. Theruvan Saranai.